This is a venomous snake. This is my false water cobra, Shelby. He's venomous. Over the last year, I've been around and handled a number of venomous snakes, like rattlesnakes, cobras, Gaboon vipers, mambas, bushmasters, and king cobras. It has been a heck of a year. A lot of these snakes could have killed me. Many would have cost me a limb. But something that many people find surprising is that most snakes are not venomous, or certainly do not pose any threat to humans at all. And even among those few snakes that are clearly venomous, some wouldn't kill you at all. Because not all snake venom is created equal. So why do they have it? What does it do to you, and how does it work? I want to start by telling you that some snakes are poisonous. This is a tiger keelback from Asia. It is poisonous. It sequesters toxins from poisonous amphibians that it eats and therefore becomes poisonous itself. This is very different from a rattlesnake like this one. You could eat a rattlesnake, every bit from nose to rattle, and even drink its venom, and you'd be fine. Unless you have a stomach ulcer. This is the worst way to find out that you have a stomach ulcer. But this is because a rattlesnake is not poisonous. It is venomous though, and so is the keelback, interestingly enough. Some keelbacks produce a medically significant venom, which is surprising when you consider how much they look like harmless little garter snakes, until you find out that they too are venomous. I know. So, hopefully, we now understand that venom and poison, while both toxins, are not the same thing. And that some snakes are poisonous, and venomous too, as it turns out. But what is venom? Well, it's a toxin. Thought you'd appreciate that. It's a toxin that requires direct delivery. This can be through fangs, as with many snakes, modified chelicerae, as with spiders, using modified legs called toxicognaths, as with centipedes, through a modified tail, as with scorpions, or a funny little leg spike, as with platypuses, using spiny barbs, as with a lionfish. There are a lot of ways to stab somebody and slide in a little bit of venom. Most snakes use one of three different methods. The simplest is to chew on something with your teeth and have the venom basically in your saliva so it gets in during the chewing. This is the method of choice for snakes like the keelback, garters, hognose snakes, mangrove snakes, false water cobras, boomslangs, and many others. I guess they don't really choose to do this, but it's the only way they can. The next method is a little more efficient. This is a pressurized system that uses muscles to squirt the venom directly through channels in the fangs right into the wound, like hypodermic needles. And this is the method used by the vipers and the elapids, which are the most notoriously venomous of the venomous snakes. But the fangs on elapids are different from the fangs on vipers. Elapids generally have fixed fangs that are basically like normal teeth, except with a venom channel running down the middle. These work just fine, but they need to be short, and the snake needs to really get its mouth around prey to envenomate them. Viper fangs, like these fangs from this Gaboon viper, are the next level in that they move. This allows them to be much, much longer and a swivel forward so that they can essentially spear prey with their fangs without needing to get a solid bite. This is the ultimate in venom delivery. Like I said, this is something that vipers can do, but at least one elapid, the death adder, has the same rockin' fang setup. So that is how snakes inject venom. But what does it do to you? Well, that depends a bit on the type of venom. Snake venom generally contains a myriad of different compounds that serve to immobilize prey, as well as aid in digestion and defense from predators. You see, there are no venomous snakes in the world that hunt humans as prey. Most snakes, even venomous snakes, have elaborate defensive displays that they perform when confronted by a human. This is because a human will win a fight with a venomous snake every time. Yeah, the human might die sometime later, but the snake dies right now. If you want to stomp a venomous snake to death, you can. And there's nothing the snake can do to stop you other than remain undetected or scare you away. Biting is the last resort, and even when they do bite, they often don't give you any of their precious venom. Venom is not for you, it's for prey. And there are two predominantly observed forms of venom in snakes, neurotoxins and cytotoxins. Neurotoxins, as their name would suggest, have an effect on the nervous system. To understand what they do to the nervous system, you need to have a bit of knowledge about nerves and how they work. Your individual nerves are actually made up of a long chain of individual nerve cells. These cells are not connected, but are separated by tiny gaps called synapses. Electrical signals are transmitted through the individual nerve cell, but when they get to the end of the cell, that charge causes the release of a chemical signal called a neurotransmitter. And this neurotransmitter is called acetylcholine. The acetylcholine travels across the synapse and binds to receptors on the next cell, causing the release of an electrical signal. The acetylcholine is then broken down by an enzyme called acetylcholine esterase, causing the signal to stop. Because it is best when you send a signal to turn your head to the left, that it doesn't stay that way for the rest of your life, right? Well, neurotoxins mess with that. Some break down the enzyme acetylcholine esterase, so the acetylcholine is never broken down and the signal never stops, causing the animal's muscles to seize up. This makes you very easy to subdue and can also cause your death directly. They can also work by preventing the electrical signal from moving down the nerve, causing the nerve to do nothing at all. This can also cause paralysis and death. They can also work by blocking the acetylcholine receptors, preventing the signal from moving from one nerve cell to the next, and again, paralyzing the nerve. This can also cause paralysis and death. And that brings us to cytotoxins. Some cytotoxins turn your cell membranes into soap, and that breaks down your cells. Some target your heart, causing it to beat irregularly, or not at all, which can cause some issues with living. Some break down your red blood cells or cause your blood to clot excessively, which again inhibits life. And that is generally how snake venom kills. Again, a lot of snake venom and components in snake venom are more dedicated to the rapid digestion of prey instead of the actual killing of prey. Incapacitating prey is important, but when you're swallowing large prey whole instead of chewing it up into smaller pieces with lots of surface area, you make yourself both immobile and vulnerable, and full of food that could easily rot before it can be digested. Getting some digestive enzymes inside while your stomach works on the outside can really speed all that up. And now you know. If you'd like to see more videos like this one in the future, please let me know down in the comments. If you like these animations or would like to know more about other science topics, please check out the Clint Explains YouTube channel as well. As always, like and subscribe, and we hope to see you real soon.